Hello everybody, good evening. Welcome to the psychiatry session. I am Dr. Sachin. I'll be taking a short topic today in psychiatry. Am I audible, visible to all? Can you just confirm in the chat box? Hi Varsha, hello Sakshi. So I have some familiar students here, identifiable names. Although it was a demo class, but I'm happy that the students who have already heard me are here to hear me again. Good. So I make sure that this time you are invested in today's lecture doesn't go wasted. Hi Indragini, I was expecting you to be here. Shreya, hello. Shall we start? Why I have selected the theme as organic mental disorders. What do we mean by the word organic? Organic means with cause. If we say psychiatric disorders or per se mental disorders, most of them are organic or functional. Most of them are functional. A few are organic. This is no batch, Arjun. This is just psychiatry. This is just Dr. Sachin. No batch. Anybody can learn psychiatry. If you wish to learn one topic in psychiatry, you are welcome to stay here for another 30 minutes. I'll discuss one chapter. The chapter name is Organic Mental Disorder, only the crisps and the brief ideas. And I'll tell you how to approach the MCQs related to this chapter. Are we on? Devita, good evening. Kostu, good evening. Yes. Bhavar Lal, good evening. Anne, good evening. Saraha, good evening. Nagraj Vittal, good evening. Do we have any student who are not Damsonians also here? Because this lecture is for all. Alright. So, organic mental disorder by definition with a cause and functional mental disorder are not a cause. So, most of the psychiatric disorders, psychiatry means or functional. Only a few are organic. For example, your schizophrenia is a functional disorder. Your depression is a functional disorder. OCD is a functional disorder. Organic mainly includes dementia, delirium, and amnestic syndrome. So those psychiatric disorders which have a cause are called organic. Those psychiatric disorders which do not have a cause are called functional. Very good. Arka Prabha Mitra. Very good. So we have regular batch students also here. Good to see you. Akanksha, good evening. Nikita, good evening. I'm happy that to see the familiar faces. Any student non-Damsonian also here? Alright. So let's differentiate organic versus functional. First difference is with a cause and without a cause. Second difference is clinically organic has visual hallucination predominant. For those who do not know about me and my teaching, anything I mark in red color in my class is an MCQ. Hi. The student named Dermat, TND student. Good name you have kept, Dermat. Already branch decided. Very good. Keep it up. And functional have auditory hallucination predominant. Why I have marked this in red color? This question has been asked 5 times. Repeated. The question is, which of the following features is suggestive of organic etiology of a mental disorder? I repeat, which of the following features is suggestive of organic etiology of mental disorder? Visual hallucination. But I said mostly, or I said predominant. Suppose they ask you, can schizophrenia have visual hallucination? Answer is yes. Less likely, but yes, schizophrenia predominantly has auditory hallucination but can have visual hallucination as well. Am I clear? Don't make it true false statement that it will only have auditory and it will only have visual. Are you understanding this? Thank you, Satya Bhatra Dash. Even I am happy to interact with you live. So I'll make sure I'll give you something more than what you have heard from me so that you gain something in coming here. Past history of psychiatric illness is more likely in this and less likely in this. Family history of psychiatric illness again is more likely here, is less likely here. Fifth, onset. It is more likely to be acute here and more likely to be gradual here. And age. It is more likely to be late onset. It is more likely to be early onset. I tell all the students, kindly do not generalize these statements, because as I mentioned, organic include delirium, dementia and amnestic syndrome. Delirium is acute, dementia is chronic. We'll be discussing that in a short while. But that doesn't mean you will make all organic as acute and all functional as chronic. Don't generalize. Why I have discussed this topic with you? This question has been asked in UPSC CMS examination 2019 and NIMHANS 2019. The question was, all are indicators of organic origin of psychiatric illness except. All are indicators of organic origin of psychiatric illness except. Listen to the question. No past history of psychiatric illness. No family history of psychiatric illness. Acute onset, early onset. Answer was early onset. Do you get this question? Do you get this question? Come on. The topic is Kinal, organic mental disorder. Welcome. I was hoping to see you from Surat. If I'm not wrong, foundation batch, final year, Surat. Am I right? Organic mental disorder. Got it? Hello, Aishwarya. Good evening. So, did you get this question? Did you get this question? Now, I will give you a master chart of organic mental disorders. Delirium, dementia, amnestic syndrome. In this master chart, you will be able to compare all these three disorders in parallel and able to solve questions related to them. Baswaraj, you said no, sir. Is the first question not clear to you? Organic versus functional. Is it not clear? Shall I repeat it? It's a live interactive class. You can ask questions. That's why I'm asking, do we have students who have not attended the previous classes, non-DAM students? those who are here to see the class for the first time. Shall I explain again? Say yes or no. I'm waiting for your answer. Okay, I'm going back to where I started. Listen, I said psychiatric disorder can be organic, can be functional. Organic means with a cause, functional means without a cause. Most of the psychiatric disorder, we do not use the word functional very common. We use a psychiatric disorder. Psychiatric disorder by rule, by convention means functional only. Schizophrenia, OCD, depression, phobia, mania, all are functional. Delirium, dementia, amnestic syndrome, DDA, whatever you call it. Delirium, dementia, amnestic syndrome fall in organic. So the first difference is cause, no cause. Second difference clinically, visual hallucination predominant, auditory hallucination predominant. Past history and family history are more likely in functional disorder, less likely in organic disorder. This is just more likely, less likely. It's not that dementia cannot have family history. Alzheimer is genetic. And it's not that schizophrenia will always have or mania will always have. Okay, so then onset, acute in organic and gradual in functional. Acute in organic and gradual in functional. Do you get this question? Baswaraj, I am repeating for you. NIMHANS 19, UPSC CMS 19, Combined Medical Services Exam. The question was, all are indicators of organic origin of psychiatric illness except no past history, number one, no family history, number two, acute onset, number three, early onset, number four. Answer was early onset because it is late onset. Do you get this now? Akanksha Baswaraj, this is an important question, important topic I have selected. So I want all students to know this. Do you get this question? If a question comes from delirium, dementia and amnestic syndrome in the upcoming NEET exam, you have to message me and let me know that this was what we attended in the demo session on 23rd December at 7:30 p.m. Got it? Can I move on? Very good question. Aspiring P. Family history means genetic concordance. Genetic concordance is more known in bipolar schizophrenia as compared to dementia and delirium. Because a schizophrenia and bipolar is more likely to have a family member with schizophrenia and bipolar rather than a dementia patient having a family history. First of all, delirium is acute, dementia is chronic, and amnestic syndrome is chronic. Delirium is fluctuating, dementia is progressive, amnestic syndrome is progressive. Then delirium is global cognitive impairment, all domains of cognition. Dementia again is global cognitive impairment, all domains. Whatever chart I am discussing now, it is very important for you people. Foundation batch and this regular batch, Arka Prabha, Kenal, Sakshi. I think previously I have taught you these three as separately in the routine classes. Today I am discussing them comparatively because I wish to finish and squeeze this in one chart in 15 minutes. It's a ultra high yield chart, so that you can differentiate comparatively. I'll just explain all these terminologies. Let's understand. First of all, the difference between dementia and amnesia. Dementia, as the name suggests, D and mentia, degenerated mental processes. Degenerated mental processes. What do you mean by degenerate? Because whenever I ask any undergraduate what is dementia, his answer is loss of memory. Let me clarify, loss of memory is amnesia, not dementia. Dementia is something bigger. D plus mentia. Let's see the definition. Global progressive cognitive decline. Cognition includes a lot of domains, not only amnesia. Amnesia is a memory. Memory is one domain of cognition. Amnesia, apraxia, agnosia, aphasia. That means language, motor, sensory. Language, motor, sensory plus speech. Multiple domains affected, judgment affected, abstract ability affected, multiple domain. Cognition is a higher mental function. Dementia is a higher mental function abnormality. Do you get it? And what is amnesia? Only memory. Even delirium has global impairment, but what is the difference? Delirium is always acute. It is always fluctuating. One moment it is present, another moment it is not present. It is non-progressive. Dementia is progressive. Then the characteristic difference between delirium and dementia is it presents with altered sensorium, that is disorientation to time, place, person. This presents with clear sensorium. These are in most of the cases. Exceptions are there. Oriented to time, place, person. This presents with clear sensorium. Oriented to time, place, person. Do you get it? Bhatia, what do you mean by consciousness? Consciousness is awareness of self and surroundings. Consciousness has two domains. One vertical domain, that is awareness, and one horizontal domain, that is alteration. So altered sensorium, some people also call it as clouding of consciousness. And this clouding of consciousness is absent in dementia and amnestic syndrome. No, there's not loss of consciousness. Loss of consciousness, my dear student, is coma, not dementia or delirium. It's a very, very common confusion among students that delirium is loss of consciousness. No. No. I'm coming to that, Sayeda. Mark it here. This is best to differentiate delirium and dementia. This question has been asked 3 times in All India exam. What is best to differentiate delirium and dementia? Sensorium. Now, memory. In delirium, new learning is affected because the patient is confused, disoriented. So, impaired attention, impaired concentration, impaired grasping. But remote memory, normal. Akanksha, fluctuating means at one moment you saw the patient, he is in delirium. At another moment you saw the patient, he is not in delirium. Patient goes in delirium, patient comes out of delirium. At 5 p.m. I saw the patient, he was in delirium. At 7 p.m. I saw the patient, he was out of delirium. Patient is not always disoriented. Intermittently oriented, intermittently disoriented. Akanksha, is your doubt clear? In dementia, new learning is also affected and remote memory is also affected. In amnestic syndrome, new learning and recent memory are affected. Remote memory is less affected. Either you can say less affected or you can say normal. Kaustubh Kumar Das, Soper, and torpor. It is just two different states of lowering of consciousness. Sopor and torpor, two different states of lowering of consciousness. Kaustubh Kumar Das, is your doubt clear? Are the students here making notes? Because this master chart is going to help you a lot for solving MCQ. Today I have brought for you three MCQs also on this topic, which I shall discuss after we complete the topic. Are you people making notes? Are you able to copy? Are you able to follow? If you wish me to slow down, I can slow down. If you miss me to speed up, I can speed up. It's a live interactive class. You can always inform me. I'm more than happy and welcome to hear the comments. Confabulation, present, absent. What is confabulation? Filling of gaps in recent memory. Filling of gaps in recent memory. It is the characteristic symptom of amnestic syndrome. What do you mean by confabulation? Filling of gaps in the recent memory. I was testing recent memory of my patient. I asked him, what did you have in dinner last night? What did you have in dinner last night? Okay. And he replied, yesterday night in dinner, I had mutter paneer. He doesn't remember what he had, but he tried to fill the gap in the recent memory. This feature is characteristic of amnestic syndrome. Characteristic of amnestic syndrome. It is not seen in delirium. It is not seen in dementia. Autonomic hyperactivity, that is tachycardia, increased BP, is seen in delirium, not in dementia, not in amnestic syndrome. So tachycardia and increased BP, that is the autonomic hyperactivity, is more suggestive of delirium rather than dementia. And amnestic syndrome. I want all the students appearing for NEET to keep this master chart. Saurabh, we can't even test apraxia agnosia because the patient is disoriented. How will you test apraxia? You tell him push the table and he will say Bharat Mata Ki Jai. When he is not understanding your commands, when he is not oriented. In delirium, when the patient is disoriented, other cognitive functions can't be tested and can't be commented upon. It's a catch. Saurabh, very good question you have asked. Although it is lost, but it is not easy to be tested. Sundowner phenomenon. What do you mean by sundowner phenomenon? Anybody knows the meaning of this? Evening worsening of symptoms. More symptoms in the evening. Technically, it is characteristic feature of delirium. Not seen in amnestic syndrome, but less likely in dementia. Because Harrison mentions that Alzheimer's can have sundowner phenomenon. You know what is sundowner phenomenon? Sundown, sundown, sunset, evening, evening worsening of symptom. Sundowner, sundown symptom increase. Suraj ast to symptom must. On a lighter note, because I can't be serious for 45 minutes. Sundowner phenomenon. शाम होते ही सिम्टम बढ़ जाते हैं. डू नो वाई? यूजली वी आर मोर डिसोरिएंटेड इन द नाइट. लैक ऑफ लाइट, लैक ऑफ फोटिक स्टिमुलेशन. ओके, दैट्स वाई द पीपल हु आर इन ICU, दे आर टोल्ड दैट दे मस्ट बी एक्सपोज टू डे लाइट फॉर सम टाइम इफ पॉसिबल. बिकॉज वेन यू आर इन द ICU यू लूज द डे नाइट ओरिएंटेशन, बिकॉज ऑल द टाइम इट इज ऑलमोस्ट इक्वल लाइट्स. अ वेरी प्रैक्टिकल टिप फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू. That's why it is advisable for you to switch off the lights in the night before sleeping. We'll not talk about these things. Sundowner phenomenon. Harrison says Alzheimer's can have. It is given in Harrison, Alzheimer can have sundowner phenomenon. Etiology. Fever infection can cause delirium. Dyselectrolemia can cause delusion. Polypharmacy, multiple medication use can cause delirium. Okay. Head trauma can cause delirium. ICU. These are the hints when you'll think about delirium. Here the etiology, as you all know, degenerative, Alzheimer's, frontotemporal, Lewy body dementia, vascular, post-stroke dementia, infections, Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, prion infection, herpes simplex virus, etc., etc. Here the commonest etiology is thiamine deficiency. Where do you see thiamine deficiency? No. Akanksha, seasonal depression is a different story. That is winter depression. That is with the season. What is the most common cause of thiamine deficiency? Chronic alcoholism. But even malabsorption syndrome can cause thiamine deficiency if the thiamine is not getting absorbed. Treatment. Treat the cause, hair treatment, anti-dementia drugs, hair treatment, thiamine. Yes, yes, post-op, of course. I have not included every point in this chart because it's a summary chart, master chart. So only some points in this chart, not the full everything. This has what you need to differentiate delirium, dementia, amnestic syndrome. Let me tell you one simple basic trick of MCQ, what I have learned in my life. I have seen many times some students who are very good in theory, they are not able to do well in MCQs. I have seen sometimes some gold medalists, some final year toppers, some MBBS toppers, they do not get the best of their ranks in NEET PG, All India, AIMS, as compared to some other of their batchmates who were performing poorer than them in the college exams. And this happened in PMT also. Do you remember 11th, 12th toppers, board toppers were not necessarily PMT, NEET, UG toppers? Do you know why? because in MCQ reading, one thing we have to keep in mind, we are not supposed to write a short note on delirium. We are not supposed to write a short note on dementia. We are not supposed to write a short note on amnestic syndrome. It is not important for me or for you to know 20 points about delirium and 20 points about dementia if you do not know that one point which will help you differentiate these two in the MCQ. This was said to me by one of my seniors, teachers and mentors. He said to me, Sachin, if you know placenta accreta, Sachin, if you know abruptio placentae, Sachin, if you know placenta previa, then that's not important, because in MCQ there will be a clinical case given and both the choices will be given, and if you know that one point which can differentiate the two, you will clear the MCQ exam. Ye bhulna mat, comparative padhna optional nahi hai, compulsory hai. Hindi, because it's emotional. Kuch students keh rahe hain ki sir maine theory padh liya, samajh aa gaya, option dekh ke confuse hote hain. Option dekh ke confuse wahi hote hain jo सिमिलर लुकिंग ऑप्शन में डिफरेंशिएटिंग पॉइंट को पकड़ नहीं पाते. ये एक आर्ट है. द स्टूडेंट्स हु से सर आई हैव नॉट रिवाइज्ड, आई एम नॉट एबल टू डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन द टू ऑप्शंस, टू ऑफ द ऑप्शंस सीम सिमिलर, दैट मींस यू डू नॉट नो दैट पिन पॉइंट व्हिच विल हेल्प यू क्लिक द एमसीक्यू. रिमेंबर, फॉर सॉल्विंग एन एमसीक्यू, रीड लाइक एन एमसीक्यू, नॉट रीड लाइक अ थ्योरी एग्जाम. इन एमसीक्यू यू आर नॉट सपोज्ड टू recall, you are supposed to recognize the correct option. Nobody is asking you, tell me 10 points about dementia. Bhulna mat is baat ko, please don't forget it. Let's solve some questions. Is the master chart useful? Is the master chart useful? Master chart of organic mental disorder. I can guarantee if you get a question on delirium, dementia, amnestic syndrome, you can solve it clinically with the help of this master chart. Shall we do some questions? Solve it. What are the key points here in diagnosis? Number one, acute pneumonia, 3 days. So the first point you got is acute infection. Number two, people in the room out to get me. People in the room, visual hallucination. Number three, not oriented to time, place. Number four, autonomic hyperactivity, pulse 126, respiration 32, blood pressure a little lower side. These four points go towards delirium or dementia. Delirium. The closest differential diagnosis of delirium is brief psychosis. Brief psychosis is functional psychosis, no cause. Delirium is organic psychosis with a cause. It is not schizophreniform disorder. Schizophreniform disorder has a duration more than 1 month. And it is not dementia because he is oriented. It is not fugue state because there is no history of travel. In fugue, in the question, you will get history of travel. solve the MCQ in such a way that you should know how to differentiate the options. The key of solving MCQ is how to differentiate the options. You must be knowing why D is answer, why not A, why not B, why not C, why not E. That's all. I've seen some MCQ book question, answer, full topic, no explanation. They just copy paste the material. And suppose I give you this question, and in explanation I just paste a chart, delirium, dementia, amnestic syndrome. That's not teaching, that's giving information. Teaching is arriving the answer from the information what you have. This is what is conceptual teaching all about. Are you able to get it? Hit the next question. Number one, 1 year illness, duration more than 6 months, forgetfulness, amnesia, visual hallucinations, suspiciousness, personality decline, poor self-care, progressive cognitive impairment. Is it only amnesia or other things also? How would you know? MMSE is a test for cognition, not only amnesia, and it is a total score of 30. Score less than 24 is suggestive of dementia. MMSE, mini mental status examination. It is not a diagnostic test, it is a screening test for dementia. Suggestive of dementia. Some student marked this question as schizophrenia. In schizophrenia, MMSC is more or less normal or not much decreased. Moreover, schizophrenia will not present with cognitive impairment in the beginning. Moreover, the age. It is not mania, no high elevated mood. It is not depression, no sadness of mood. Got it. This question sounds simple now because we have just discussed organic mental disorder and you are solving it, but sometimes students mark it as schizophrenia. Is this clear? Because of the presence of suspiciousness, visual hallucination. Please remember, visual hallucination means organic, less likely to be schizophrenia. Do you get it? Do you get this question? Can we move on to the third and the last question of the day? Third and the last question of the day. Can we move on to the third and the last question of the day? Now this is a tricky one. Prolonged alcohol use greets the resident of her nursing home, calls him, "My dear friend Raman." The physician explains who he is and tells the patient his name. 2 minutes later, he asks, "Who is?" "You are my cousin Rahul from New Jersey. First of all, tell me, what is the sign shown?" Come on, fastest finger first. A few minutes ago, the physician told, "I am Rahul," but he says, no, "I am Raman." No, then he says, "Rahul." Yes, very good. Swapna Moe Ghosh. The sign is confabulation. Can you tell me the diagnosis? Come on, fastest finger first. What is the diagnosis? What is the diagnosis? Full diagnosis. chronic alcoholism, recent memory loss, confabulation. What is the diagnosis? Say complete. Korsakoff, amnestic syndrome. Which memory is lost? Which memory is lost? Recent memory. Now, this is a prize winning question. Which brain part involvement is responsible for memory loss in Korsakoff? Which brain part involvement is responsible for memory loss in Korsakoff? I want the name of the brain part. Which brain part involvement is responsible for the memory loss in Korsakoff? Fastest finger first. Come on. I'm waiting for you people to answer. Kinal, no, it is not hippocampus. Korsakoff, no, Swapnamoy, it is not corpus callosum. Anybody else? Sudeshna, mammillary body is involved, but more than that, there is something else which is responsible for the memory loss in Korsakoff. Memory loss in Korsakoff is due to dash damage. Fill in the blanks. Dash damage, brain part. Three of you have tried. Sakshi, wrong answer. Jyoti, wrong answer. Yes, Kinal, it is thalamus. Usually student answer it as hippocampus because they believe recent memory is hippocampal, but Korsakoff memory loss is due to thalamic damage. What is the hallmark symptom of Korsakoff? We have already said this. Confabulation. What is the cause of Korsakoff? What is the cause of Korsakoff? Come on, cause. Thiamine deficiency. What is the treatment? Thiamine. Technically, the students who have attended to me in the last 40 minutes session, go back home and check how many MCQs we have covered. Organic versus functional, that gives you 3 MCQs. Delirium, dementia, amnestic syndrome chart, that gives you 5 MCQs, and these 3-5 more. Approximately 20 MCQ we have covered in the last 40 minutes. This is the speed, this is the strike rate with which you have to study. This was just a demonstration, this was just a way how you are supposed to approach, how you are supposed to learn a topic, how you are supposed to grasp conceptually. Okay, so that's all for the day where I'm winding up. If there's any non-DAM students here who wishes to know about any of the DAMS courses or any details about the DAMS programs, I am very much reachable. There's a YouTube channel, Dr. Sachin Arora Psychiatrist, where I'll be uploading this video as well as other videos of psychiatry. There's a Facebook page, Dr. Sachin Arora DAM Psychiatry. Okay, there's a Telegram channel, DAM Psychiatry Updates. I have a Telegram group also, WhatsApp groups also for students. And there's an Instagram. So I'm very much reachable at all the social media things. And this is the email ID and the WhatsApp number. For the patients interested, this is the clinic where I work, Dwarka, New Delhi. Okay, so that is all for the day. Okay, if anybody wishes to reach me, please take a pic of this and keep it with you. Okay, regarding the DAMS Ultimate Live course, I have this referral code. If you wish to copy it, you can copy it. Okay, it's one of its kind courses we are launching, already launched. If you have any queries, you can get back to me with this course or any of the DAMS courses, for resident, for super speciality, for undergraduates, MBBS students. I'll be more than happy to answer your queries. Thank you. Good night. That's all for the day. Thank you very much. Dr. Sachin Arora signing off.